JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for January the 6th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all the other G10 currencies on Tuesday during the Asian session Wednesday. It fell the most against the Aussie, the Kiwi and the Loonie in that order, while it underperformed the least versus the Swiss franc, the British pound and the Japanese yen. The relative weakness of the safe havens dollar, yen and franc, combined with the strengthening of the commodity-linked Aussie, Kiwi and Loonie, suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion. That said, taking a look at the equity world, we see that most of the major EU indices closed in negative waters. The exception was UK's FTSE 100, which gained 0.61%, boosted by oil majors Royal Dutch, Shell and BP, as oil prices rebounded following Saudi Arabia's decision to agree and make additional voluntary cuts of 1 million barrels per day in February and March. This was part of a deal to persuade other producers in the OPEC Plus group to keep output steady. Sentiment improved during the US session, with Wall Street's main indices gaining 0.74% each, but it eased again during the Asian session today, perhaps as investors sat on their hands in anticipation of the Georgia election outcome. With 96% of the votes being counted, Democrats and Republicans appear locked in tight races, with the final results expected to be announced later today. As we noted yesterday, a Democratic sweep could raise speculation that the president-elect Biden's fiscal agenda will pass much more easily, which could mean higher stimulus spending. Therefore, the dollar is likely to continue to slide, while equities are likely to continue marching north. A Democratic-controlled Congress could also mean higher taxes and more regulation, which is negative for stocks, but we still believe that due to the coronavirus vaccinations, the fiscal support in the US, the monetary policy easing around the globe, and the Brexit trade accord, the path of least resistance for equities and other risk-linked assets may be to the upside. At the same time, we expect safe havens like the US dollar and the Japanese yen to stay under selling interest, especially against the risk-linked currencies like the Aussie and the Kiwi. Now, as for today's events, today the main release may be the minutes from the latest FOMC gathering, at which officials kept policy unchanged but changed their forward guidance, saying that they will continue to buy bonds until substantial further progress has been made towards the committee's maximum employment and price stability goals. At the press conference following the decision, Fed Chair Powell said that the recovery has been quicker than expected, but he added that they remain open to increasing bond purchases or moving to longer maturities, and if they feel that this will help the economy, they will do it. With that in mind, we will scan the minutes for clues as to how willing Fed officials are to loosen their policy further, and if so, when further action may take place. As for the data, the final services PMIs for December from the Eurozone, the UK and the US are due to be released, but as it is always the case, they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. We also get Germany's preliminary inflation numbers for December. The CPI rate is expected to have remained unchanged at minus 0.3% year over year, while the HICP1 is forecast to have ticked up to minus 0.6% year over year from minus 0.7%. With regards to the energy market, we get the Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week, which is expected to reveal a 1.271 million barrels slide following a 6.065 million stumble the week before. With the American Petroleum Institute reporting a 1.663 million barrel slide yesterday, we would consider the risks surrounding the Energy Information Administration forecast as tilted somewhat to the downside. Now, tonight, during the Asia session Thursday, Australia's trade balance and building approvals for November are coming out. The nation's trade surplus is expected to have declined to 5.800 billion Aussies from 7.456 billion, while the building approvals are forecast to have declined 3% month over month after rising 3.8%. We also have one speaker on today's agenda, and this is Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.